for the past few days, a document was circulating on social media, and even mainstream print and electronic media also touched on it. A document supposedly showing a renunciation certificate or the citizenship of Gotabaya Rajapaksa. Now, this we know now that it's confirmed that it was a fake document. But the necessity to create something like that brings us to a whole different point. Now, we know that in 2015, the presidential election depended a lot on the social media aspect. And right now, we are seeing a tendency in the social media to move towards a lot of fake news and to base the policies on those fake news items. Because I'm talking about this because as soon as this document was published on social media, even the print media, the politicians, the whole country, in fact, looked at it and, you know, sort of went with it. So this trend that you are seeing on social media, if you agree with me, how do you view this?
I mean, it's like that all over the world because social media has disrupted the entire media landscape, and I mean, social media has become the media.
Yeah.
I mean, to tell you the truth, I know people in the mainstream media are reluctant to accept this, but that's the reality that we have to deal with. And especially Sri Lankans, they still don't know, they still haven't figured this out, in my opinion. They have very low social media literacy, and especially when it comes to understanding the authenticity of a story or something that they see or hear on social media. But in terms of Mr. Gotabaya Rajapaksa's letter, he himself confirmed that it's a fake document, but today a Sinhala newspaper carried the original Maubima newspaper carried the original letter, and I think Mr. Gotabaya Rajapaksa's official spokesman also confirmed when he tweeted the letter. I saw it in the evening. So now it's clear that Mr. Gotabaya Rajapaksa has renounced his US citizenship. That means he's getting ready to run for the election, and that was expected, I think, in their camp. There's a lot of expectation, and almost everyone wanted Mr. Rajapaksa to run because they perceived him as the next best choice after former President, opposition leader Mahinda Rajapaksa. But there's another interesting point, Chaturanga. Now, in terms of Mr. Rajapaksa's citizenship, now, 19th Amendment to the Constitution prevented dual citizens from running for the presidency, right?
Yes.
Interestingly, the 19th Amendment, the Presidential Election Act of Sri Lanka is yet to be amended in line with the 19th Amendment to the Constitution, right? And then, the Elections Commissioner, Chairman of the Elections Commissioner can't check whether a candidate is a dual citizen at the time of giving him the nomination to run for the election.
Right.
So technically, as far as I know, Mr. Rajapaksa can still run for the election even without this letter from the US. Mm-hmm. So he can still run for the election, but anyone who has a problem with his candidacy will have to challenge it after the election. They have to take the Geetha Kumarasinghe route, and that will take some time.
Yeah.
And so very interesting dynamics from what I see, but now it's clear that Mr. Rajapaksa will run for the election, and I think the Sri Lanka Podujana Peramuna is now getting ready to announce his candidacy. Some of them, even their key spokespersons, have made it clear that they'll make the final announcement on August 11th at the National Convention of the party. Again, the same dynamics I explained earlier
apply here.
So I don't know why they are trying to do it at this point, like 5 months before the election. So let's see.